tester. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Tester. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Tester. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Testing. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Once again, it's 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. All right, I think we're good.
Hello.
We managed.
Yeah.
We managed to get through. And we also learned a little bit about the PlayStation camera.
Yep.
While doing so. That's good. Let me just check if everything is well. The audio. Good. Yeah. Awesome.
Cool.
I think we're live. Hey, Niels, how's it going, man?
Hey man, I'm excited to play Journey.
Yeah, you've waited for
forever.
Came out like 4 years ago.
Yeah.
Let me
for
see.
This opportunity.
That's awesome.
I knew we were gonna do this.
So anyone out there watching? Sorry for our faces.
Yeah.
No. Yeah. So Modem, we're trying something new. We wanted to do like a stream, see how that could work out. So today we'll be playing Journey. A lovely game made by That Game Company.
Yep.
It's the third one. They agreed with Sony making three games. The first one being Flow, second one being Flower, and finally Journey came out, which I think is the best one and the like received.
Yeah, most
best
critically
amongst
acclaimed.
The yeah, exactly. So
sure.
Let's get started. It's
yeah.
We. Think of it, the game should last like an hour and a half, so
hopefully if yeah. I can I'm the one who's gonna be playing, so
that's
you
perfect.
Can blame me if we go over time, but yeah, let's experience this,
so give it a go. I've seen this before, so this will be completely new to
yeah,
you.
Yeah, I've never I'm just completely blank on what's gonna happen.
That's cool. All right, I'm gonna set up in the back while you watch this.
All right. Oh, good idea. Yeah. You're wondering if it's mirrored or not?
I can't remember the logo. There we go. Ain't that pretty?
Yay! We have a new streamer. Welcome. So we just started playing. You didn't miss anything.
Man.
You could also write a modem underneath.
Oh yeah, good idea. All right. And I think you're actually playing the game now.
Yeah.
Oh wow.
So we're started, and I'm tilting the controller here. I don't know what's happening. If I'm supposed to do anything.
I think it's for moving the camera.
Oh yeah, oh. We needed to turn around.
Oh, I forgot how pretty this game
yeah,
is.
Yeah, this looks really good. I'm gonna run for the hill with this stuff on top.
That's cool. I'll ride modem.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know how good I'll be at the font though, but
no.
We'll see.
Okay, so I'm trying to push buttons here. I see that I get some sort of signal whenever I push the circle button, but I can't jump. Let's see if that changes later on. So we're at the top now, almost.
Oh well. Great. That was quick.
I think this is our goal.
Oh, that's the name of the game.
Yeah, this is a really cool way of introducing the game.
Yeah, so I think mainly we'll just be talking about whatever's going on,
yeah.
What you're experiencing. I have like found some background stuff that we'll get into a little bit further in the game. So you're not going to be spoiled or anything.
Yeah. Ooh, I'm sliding down the hill. I'm curious to see what these are.
The sound is just amazing.
Okay, I can't do anything with this. So I'm guessing the white signal over there is where I wanna go.
Ah. I do not remember this game. Like I remember it, but I have no idea what happened in it. But it's a really good game.
Yeah, so I've heard like everyone is supposed to love it. So.
That's actually like, and I think that's why it's good you haven't played it or like seen anything, because
yeah.
I read an article, it just got released for the PS4 together with the two other games in a collection like, what was that, a year or 2 years ago?
Yeah.
It was originally released on the PS3, and one of the things that was so special about Journey was that no one knew kind of anything about it.
Yeah.
And going into that like, to that game without having any expectations and any knowledge of it was actually one of the very like one of the things that made the game so critically acclaimed, I think, because people didn't really know anything about it. Oh, now you can jump now?
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
And I think we got another streamer. All right. I'm not sure what I'm supposed to do with these.
Oh, that's cool.
Oh, now they're following me.
But what that means is that when they re-release it in on the PlayStation 4, basically now people know of it, people know of the game, people have expectations for it, and many of the people who will probably be playing the re-release will have played the original game, so it's a much different experience to go through, I think, the second time and the third time.
Yeah. Okay, so I could only jump over here, and I get the feeling I'm supposed to sort of get the pieces to go with me, but I don't know how.
You lost your jumping abilities?
Yeah, I can only jump while I'm around these things, it seems. And unless I know how to move them, Yeah, this is probably gonna take more than 1.5 hours now.
We'll see. I think it'll be okay.
Okay. So now I'm getting closer again, and now I can jump. Maybe I've missed something that I'm supposed to interact with, or...
I think maybe you can only jump when they are around for now. Maybe? I'm not sure.
Okay, let's just move on.
So if I... talk a little bit about like the development of the game, because as I said, this was like the third game in a 3-game contract that game company did with Sony, and it was delayed for a long time. Like, it was originally supposed to have a 1-year development cycle, got pushed to 2 years, and eventually they actually had to ask Sony, like, we need another year. So it was postponed a couple of years, but I think the end result was pretty great. I think it came to be really polished. Mm-hmm. And as you already know, you can probably play through the game in 1.5 hours, maybe 2 hours, which was one of the big, like, kind of like critical points of the game, that it was too short. And I read an interview about the guy who made it, that part of it was making it short so that people, like adult people, could enjoy it, because they usually don't have 6 hours to sit down and play a game. Usually they don't have like 1 hour, maybe 2 hours. So it was to make an experience that was not just for young people or people with more time than like...
I also like thinking about the challenge of trying to create something very compact.
Ah, someone's helping out here. They're saying they are charging your scarf and you can glide while your scarf is charged.
Okay.
So that's what you're...
awesome.
Thank you.
But yeah, I guess I should just move on here.
But I think that was a really interesting point, like... in like creating a game that was... that's this... I want to say artistic, even though it doesn't seem right, but...
No, it is definitely an arts project.
Yeah, and like... Flow and Flower, the previous two games, were very like relaxed experience.
Oh, I'm experiencing heavy wind now. This is really cool.
Oh no!
It's my controls are all messed up right now. I don't. Maybe it's because I'm not supposed to go here. I don't know.
Oh wow! I got blown back. But yeah, it's definitely a more of like a feeling kind of game. When you hear the developers talk about it, they're like, they don't want to, but they feel like people what we should look into when designing games is like designing feelings and looking for feelings.
Feelings
in people. Yeah. Which I thought was really interesting, because it wasn't the first game to do it, but it kind of started a genre of like, this is telling a story, not necessarily with a lot of gameplay, but like through visuals and some interaction. Like I mentioned, other games like Gone Home, like walking simulators, or where it's like really the story is in focus, but you just get that much more involved since you're kind of playing, interacting with the game. So
I think I have to charge my scarf here and then go over there and jump up.
Yeah. I think you might be right. Oh, people are really helping out. That's awesome.
I don't know if it's cheating if you're just telling
that's
me the answers
here. No. They're just like commenting, like saying that playing the game again, like it only adds up on top of the first one.
Okay.
It's like you go through in like an hour and a half, and then you're like, oh, and then you play through it again, and you understand more, and you play through it again. You're like super.
So there's more layers
movies.
To
yeah,
playing
exactly.
it more than once.
I think so.
Okay, so now my scarf is bigger, so I'm guessing I can jump more. But I just have to find a place that I feel like I'm supposed to jump up to.
Yeah. Probably that one in the middle would be good.
Yeah, I don't know if I should go to that charging station, I'm calling it now. Whoop, too far.
Okay, oh yeah.
Alright, oh I see. I didn't even need to jump. I can just go up here. I'm betting people are getting frustrated with this.
Well, I mean, this is the first time playing a game. You're always going to be like, why are they not doing this?
Yeah.
Didn't you see that? Looking at the computer half the time, so I'm not much of a help.
I saw something I should get here. Oh.
Oh, wow. Whoa. That definitely did something.
Yeah. Okay, so now we have bigger pieces of... now I can use this circle thing.
Oh, wow. Oh!
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Fay Mary.
Hi.
So someone entered the room. I don't
you
know
want to
what's
join us? Or you want to take pictures?
Pictures.
Oh.
Okay.
That was what I was expecting. I would be like, oh shit, I have to find another mic. Yeah.
Okay, now I'm getting a really heavy scarf.
Oh, wow.
This is gonna be great. I think I should jump over the bridge here.
Yep, yep. Oh.
Woo!
No issues.
Okay, I'm activating these by going close to them.
And that's it, Nils. You just completed journey. How was it?
Awesome, awesome. No, I think it's an atmospheric game so far.
You can go walk behind the camera if you want.
I'm just curious how you figured out where we are. Oh, okay.
So I helped out.
Okay. So it's sort of abstract what they're telling us here.
Yeah, very.
So I guess that's why you can play it more than once.
Exactly. It's kind of a double-edged sword. I don't want to... Let's just watch with this first.
Yeah. I guess when we're through the game, we can discuss it.
Yeah,
sounds good. So we don't go through too many spoilers here.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
But like games like these, where it's like... They don't give you a lot, and you have to interpret the rest.
Yeah.
It's always, to me, it's like a double-edged sword. Because what I will do is I will go online and like Google like what are other people thinking of this. Like, oh, that makes sense.
Yeah.
And well, I can't really figure out if that's a good or a bad thing. Like it's kind of meta thing. But I think, without saying too much, that in Journey, like there is definitely a story. It's not like how people interpret it. It's like there's a story, but it's not like given directly to the player. So.
Yeah.
Which I think is the great balance between like saying something and not saying everything.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, wow. This is so pretty. I mean, you're completely lost in a desert and everything, but
yeah, and it's not like there's a lot of polygons or anything, but the art direction is really what makes it.
The sand when you were like tripping from the wind looked really fucking amazing.
Yeah, it did. I've seen that in, I think, Uncharted 3. They did the same kind of...
Yeah.
Kind of maybe I should just jump out here.
Whee.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Or Lara walking in snow.
Oh, yeah. All right.
We'll see if you can... Okay, there was the head of...
Right, okay. Walking by.
Okay, there is a piece of ribbon that I can probably interact with.
Okay. Here, I can move it. Whoop.
But
thank
I already
you.
Did this, now I'm doing it again. Okay.
Oh.
Ooh, release all the bands. Okay, scarf bridge. So if this is anything like the puzzles in Uncharted, I should go around all visit all the scarves in the circle here. But I can try just go up here first. I'm always conflicted if I should do what I think I should, like, this is what I'm supposed to do, or, like, which of the two are they trying to lead me to do first? I never know.
Oh, yeah.
So, but yeah, I can see here I'm gonna get the next piece of the bridge.
Yeah.
And that experience I wouldn't have gotten if I just went out and took all the ribbons at once.
Yeah, that's, like, the worst in, like, games where you look for collectibles, where, like, there are obviously two paths here, and, like, if you're looking for, like, the extra side stories, like, collectibles, like, you don't want to take the obvious path, but so you don't know which one, because, like, if you go the correct path, you're like, oh, shit, I have to go back now. So...
And I think I often end up choosing the correct path first, because I try to choose the one that's least obvious, which I think the developers are trying to... handle that you're not supposed to do that, so they kind of double reverse psychology, I think. So we got another streamer. I think we're up to five including you.
Yay! If you guys out there, let me know, like, audio-wise, if some audio is too loud, some audio is too...
Yeah, if it's, like, compared to the game audio or anything. We're running this kind of ghetto audio setup with a lot of wires, so...
That's putting it polite, a lot of wires.
Oh, yeah, if you could see the table over here.
Glad the camera is pointed that way.
Yeah. Okay, I think I'm gonna go for all the pieces of scarf.
I think that sounds a good idea. Like, a good idea.
Otherwise, I'll be going back and forth a lot. So how close do I need to be?
Ooh, good enough. Tricky. Release the scars.
Yeah, I'm wondering, who were they trapped by? Oh, and I can get a bigger piece of scarf up there. If I can get up there.
Oh, no.
Secret level. Alright. Awesome.
Well, that was a surprise.
Yeah.
But it came out of nowhere.
This time I'm pretty sure they tried to lead me up there by putting something higher up.
Definitely.
But I don't know what I'm learning from this. Things in the sky above the buildings. Something like that. Oh, more stuff. Wait, what? I just... Oh, I came out on the same side. I see. Oh, another player.
Oh. Hello, mate. How are you doing?
This is so awesome. I mean... The thought that you're not sure if you're gonna meet anyone.
Oh, he'll show you. Okay, do like he did.
Is this one of the streamers that's joined and helping me out?
So jump on the platform up there. Yeah, the little one, the gray one, and then jump from that one. That's what he did.
Okay, but I have to get more scarf points first.
Oh yeah, sorry.
So where am
so,
I going?
So jump on the little one, just that one, the gray one, the box where you release the scarves.
Okay.
That's what he did, at least.
But or should I?
Up there?
Okay.
And then you should be able to jump the rest of the way.
Okay.
At least that's what the other person did.
No!
Almost. Or maybe not. At least they succeeded.
It looks like this is what I'm supposed to do. Did he leave me? No, he's there.
Show us, friend. Or maybe you... Do you need super scarfed powers?
But it doesn't make sense because this is the place that I'm gonna get better scarf powers.
Oh, yeah.
Maybe I should stand on this corner? This is a bit higher up.
Do it!
Oh, shh.
No. Never mind. Reverse.
It's becoming a bit annoying that I can't... I know I can't jump up here because it will use my scarf power. Yeah. Ah!
Maybe someone's...
Ah!
Morton is writing scarf power. Lol. Yeah. All right, you can do it, Niels. Okay.
No, I can't. Yeah, I can't even get up on the ledge.
Recharge. Recharge.
No, he's jumping on his own accord now. I'm not asking him to do anything.
All right, just go for it, and otherwise we'll continue.
Come on, come on, come
without
on.
Without getting the collectible.
Oh no, yeah!
Oh, nice.
All right.
That was almost going to be a big failure.
Yeah. No, I'm going to get a...
Woo! Oh, that's a scarf power.
Going to get hung.
Ah!
No.
I see. So now you can use more scarf powers, yeah. I guess.
And go to the next scarf place.
Just look out you don't, like, get choked. Like a dark ending all of a sudden, like...
I am wondering how dark this will get. If at all.
Constantine is saying, damn it, now I want to play too. Like, he can probably catch up and help us out.
Yeah, he should. Constantine, you should join us and help us out, because I'm apparently not very good at deciphering these puzzles. Oh, I see something in the distance.
We've done well.
I mean, this is a pretty big place.
Oh, up there. Grab those two.
I'm wondering if this is just a part of the level, or is this actually the whole challenge? Because I think it looks like there are pieces quite far out. We'll see.
Someone here is suggesting that you should exhaust your scarf and then stand next to another player.
Okay, well, the other player left us. But if we find someone else, we'll try it next time someone shows up.
Definitely do that.
Oh, so we can charge each other, maybe. I see.
Oh, and you created
now the
bridge.
Bridge is complete.
Yay!
I am complete.
That was my comment, by the way.
Oh, okay.
Just so you are aware.
I'm wondering why you're not. Oh, there's a player over there. No, don't leave me. How can he move so fast? Oh, it's the wind. He's like getting way ahead of me. Okay.
Are those something you can activate, or are they just... For
Let's see. Definitely? There was also something in the...
Nope.
Oh, it changes the pattern, didn't it?
Ah. Oh, maybe they're
didn't.
Just different all the time.
Okay, but there's some piece out here as well that I want to go for. All
right.
So I never know if I'm supposed now that the first... bridge piece is solved. Should I go out here and find that piece, or should I come back later? Or and where?
I think definitely going up that bridge is like continuing the game.
Yeah, exactly. So
if you want to get that one, you should grab that one too while we're at it. So I'm gonna get into a little bit of there we go. Hey buddy. Oh, you're charging him.
Yeah.
Ah.
And now he didn't see me, I guess.
Oh, so maybe that's like. I mean, before it seemed like a very, like, rigid place, like you needed to be exactly at this point. Maybe it's like you're supposed to jump together and then you can charge each other on the way up or something.
Yeah, but then that would require that people will keep on playing this for years to come. You won't know if that's... So I'm noticing that when I turn around, there's this wide edge.
Yeah.
So it's like I'm supposed to turn around. Okay, I'll follow this guy.
Yeah.
Can we charge each other? Yeah.
Oh.
While we're both depleted. Nice. I'll let him take the lead.
Hey, buddy.
I really like the way they handle this way of forcing you to interact with other people, because you get an advantage by it sticking together.
Yeah.
I think this is really, really cool. Can you go up there?
Maybe he's just as confused as we are.
Yeah.
Maybe he's another guy streaming from another university. Be like, I'm trying to stream this for the first time. These guys just won't help me.
Yeah, you can't go up here. Or you can. Okay.
Definitely. Yeah, an invisible wall.
Okay. The wind is telling us no.
I think we should maybe continue up there.
Yeah, I'll just...
Things. See you, man. Or follow us.
Maybe he'll go with us. We'll see.
Take the lead.
But,
guy from
I
KU.
Mean, we don't really know if he's solved as much pieces of the bridge as I have, or we have, so...
No, that's true.
But the wind is guiding us now.
So I'm gonna ask you a little like question here, Niels. So what do you think that this game and God of War 3 have in common? Those two games, what do they have in common?
That's a really strange question. I think they're really, really different.
Well, so I'm gonna spoil it here. So what they have in common is that they had the same sound audio designer.
Okay, that, yeah, I wouldn't have guessed that.
Oh, what? Everybody
knows
that.
It's been like years since I played it.
No, yeah, so there's like this guy, Steve Johnson, who's like worked apparently on this and also on God of War 3, which is funny because like in an interview he's like saying that they actually used some of the same audios, like audio sources, like audio bits for God of War 3 as this game. So it's like part of the things you hear in God of War 3 has also been used in this game, which I think is pretty interesting.
Yeah.
Oh, he followed you up here.
Yeah, he did. We're friends, and he activated the same pieces, or the rest. Yeah, all right, we've got a friend we can continue moving on with. Awesome.
All right, we'll watch this. I'll continue my audio design story afterwards.
Yep. Okay, so we're moving up in the world, I guess. And the ribbons lead us on. It's a train. On a monorail.
Ah.
You can hear the train sound effects. Right, wow. Another streamer. A viewer, I guess it's called, actually.
Yeah. We'll call it whatever we want.
Yeah, but I think that makes more sense.
How many do we have to get before we can give them, like, a nickname? Like, Bieber? Justin Bieber, he has Beliebers. What do Modem get?
Like, we've got Modebers? No.
We'll figure something out.
Yeah. Maybe someone in the comments will tell us, so we don't have to spend brain energy on that.
Yeah, so like the sound design is this has been like it's one of the main points where
this is really pretty.
People love it.
Pre-recorded.
There's been like so many accolades and one thing is just like audio effects. Also, like the music is phenomenal.
Mm-hmm.
I'll have stories about that later. But some of the sounds, like, it's interesting to hear about Steve Johnson, how he produced some of them, like. Because there's so much sand in the game.
Mm-hmm.
So what he had was like a 3x3 foot square, like a little box with sand that he grabbed from Venice Beach. And he was just in his office making all these small noises of it. And like when you walk, like some of those noises are like a hacky sack. And he talks about like how he created the different ones. I don't want to go through all of them.
Yeah.
But some of them are like pretty interesting. Like some of them cost him a pair of jeans that he was dragging alongside in a parking lot. So
okay.
But
I think sound engineering for games or sound design is a really cool thing.
Oh yeah.
I just saw that a post from I don't even remember where it was, but the inside they recorded all of the music inside of a human skull.
Oh yeah.
Or all of the sound. And that's just, I think that's pretty interesting. I mean, you can't directly hear it in the game, but I guess it adds to the sound.
Yeah, yeah, it's just
like fingerprint or whatever.
Yeah.
Oh, we've got a cloth friend here.
Oh, is it saying something? Can you say something back to it?
That's squawking at me. I can try to do this.
Come back, buddy. We like you.
Ooh. He entered.
Oh, yeah. What's it saying? That definitely did something.
This is really cool that he started doing this after I pressed it. Ooh, more scoff friends.
Trying to find...
So I'm wondering what the difference between what the player... how the player helps me and these AIs... Oh, I can ride it!
Thank you!
Very, very nice.
I guess we're going that way. Oh, wow!
See, a building. It's like a lost civilization. I mean, the setting kind of, it does remind me of when they go to the Robotkali Desert in Uncharted 3.
Yeah.
It's kind of, I know it's not the same game, but I'm getting the same kind of isolation feel and having these old buildings that are broken down. Okay, so he's going that way, I'm gonna follow him.
So, can you make a sound? So, those are like birds, but like repitched and like tweaked in various different ways. But those are bird sounds originally.
So I think it's can hear how it could be then. Yeah.
That's crazy. If you want to watch a really interesting, you know what? Screw it. I'm gonna find it and put it in the. I'm thinking like, no, I should not put something that other people should go watch while
don't redirect people from here.
But once you're done with this, you should go find behind the scenes for The Evil Within, like the horror game for the audio design. It's this cool guy who's like in his office, his small office, and he goes and buys like a ton of groceries, like watermelons and like noodles, wet noodles, and like, and he creates all these like nasty sounds for people biting into like.
I saw the same thing from The Last of Us.
It's incredible.
This game design or sound design.
Super cool.
So where are we going, buddy?
Did you have to do something in there?
There was a scarf enhancer.
Okay. Oh, nice.
Which we are calling now. That's what we're calling it. I kind of want to go get a puncho now after playing this. Help me out, guys.
Oh, yeah, they definitely did something. Well, maybe you should follow the...
Yeah, the carpets.
Fish.
I'm thinking this is a flying carpet, definitely.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. I agree. Aladdin's got nothing on us.
I can show you the world.
So we can do a little bit of behind the scenes on our own. The reason why it took us like another 8 minutes to get started was because the PlayStation camera kept recognizing one of our faces and zooming in.
Yeah.
So it was either you or me for the entire stream. And we thought that these two beautiful faces.
Like, yeah, you wouldn't want to miss any of them.
So we couldn't figure out, like, there was no option to reset it, which was crazy. But we eventually found a solution, at least to say Sony get on it. Like, goddamn, that was...
Yeah, it's like they don't want you to be more than one person streaming.
So is that the same thing you saw in the beginning of the game?
I think this is where we're headed in the end.
Okay,
I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
So maybe we should cross here, but we probably need to do the same thing that we did at the last point, where we need some extensions.
What's going on over there?
See, we probably need to go somewhere and find these pieces of cloth. That's my guess. He's trying it out. I'm gonna.
You go first, buddy.
Yeah. Like, there's something down there.
Could you get over? Yeah, it seems like you can get up over there. Yes. They're definitely. I'm wondering what that wide, if that's like indicating where to go or where your friends are or something.
Oh,
or
yeah, like it could be
close to.
Oh, no, he indicates where he is by making a sound. There's a white bubble. I found him like.
Okay. Ah, that's what it is.
Yeah. I think. It's a very elegant solution. It's not like we don't have to have an in-game chat
or
anything.
No, exactly. It's just. Saying like bleep.
Oh, is he having a snack now or something?
Okay, it seems like you can jump that one. Or maybe.
Yeah.
Maybe not.
Our friend is not playing anymore. Yeah, I think we should continue without him.
he went to get a drink. He's like, I'm getting out of here.
Maybe he didn't realize that I would find him.
So can that one recharge you? Try to...
Yeah, I'm not quite sure.
So that recharges you. Oh, wow.
And I can even ask it to take me places.
What was that? Ah.
So like that.
Hells, you're learning. So it should, get you up to the top. Wow. Well, that was easy. Without any help from anyone else.
I guess it's a good thing that our friend didn't lead us all the way. I kind of stopped thinking when he showed up.
Well, that's one of the things I read as well, that people playing this for the first time, they suggest that you actually turn off the multiplayer option.
Okay.
Just so you can experience it firsthand, like your own. Yeah. The first time through. Yeah. I know right now we're in kind of a different setting because, I mean, we're here and we're online and I'm here and like everything. But but that's at least a good idea for other people if they want to play this for the first time.
Should I do something for these
Again,
guys?
Going back to the theme of... Oh, that one over there can probably help you. Like going back to the theme of like not knowing anything about the game.
Yeah.
Sometimes like that's part of it.
Yeah, it's... kind of weird way, but they're playing with another guy, spoiling what to do.
Yeah, exactly.
Except that the other guy also didn't know where to go.
That's true. Oh, another one of these.
Yeah, I think we're moving on to the next level now.
But like in like MMOs, like where cooperation is kind of part of it, where you ask other like, where's this item, how can I get this?
Yeah.
This is not about multiplayer, this is about your journey. Whoa, look at me.
Yeah, you don't want... Yeah. I see what you did there. Oh, yeah, but it's definitely more... You don't want to look up walkthrough...
No.
...articles or something.
Definitely not. Let's see what goes on here.
So we have this kind of mother figure that we're trying to find, I think. Towers.
Interesting.
I'm wondering if this is the lost civilization of the Scarf people or...
Scarf power! Maybe it is.
Oh, they even have some sort of mechanics in the world.
Oh, you released a bunch of them.
Yeah.
Hey, people.
And they have... They make sounds Scarf-ish. Like they're... Oh, those were the bird sounds we were talking about.
Okay, so if you jump on this guy, I think falling off is a bad idea. It seems like right now you don't want to be on the ground.
Oh, okay, shit.
That's just me.
That's what you said. I'm supposed to move forward. That was oddly happy music for...
Oh, maybe they just like brought you to a new place.
Okay.
It just looked like it was going to be a storm downstairs.
I just fell down and died, and then there was just happy violent music.
No, okay, they're just carrying you.
That's good.
Oh, wow.
Ooh, now we have some more...
Surfing.
...speedy environment.
Do a jump.
Yeah, I'm going to jump over here.
360, hop. Woo, well done. Wow, this looks amazing.
Yeah, I'm liking this. Maybe I can get up there.
Help us!
No.
Oh, wow. Things got super fast-paced all of a sudden.
Yeah, I like the change in and pace in the game now.
All right, go, little boy. Go. Go, Nils, go. Stop! Or not.
Am I still controlling it?
That's sure.
Yes, I am. Nice.
Can you land on over to the right?
Oh, yeah.
Come on. You can do it. Get it.
Huh? No.
Oh! All right, we'll have to restart the game.
Yeah. I hope you guys have an extra hour for this.
Close, but no cigar.
Yeah, that was a bummer. I had no more scoff power, so... Okay.
What we have
so
here?
So these are the scarves that I'm gonna release, I think. I'm wondering if this is like a different scarf clan that, or why they're stuck in there.
Morden is sad because we didn't get the extra one.
Yeah, me too.
He's like, no.
When I get home, I'm gonna have to play it again.
Yeah. Well, that's the good part about being a shorter game, I guess.
Yeah.
Do you replay a lot of games?
Some, like I've already mentioned Uncharted, I've played through Uncharted 2, I think, 5 times.
Whoa.
Yeah, for some reason I decided to play through from medium settings and just take it one notch up all the way until, I played through the first 3 Uncharteds on the hardest difficulty.
Yeah.
I've yet to do it with Uncharted 4, so... I'll do that at a later point, I think.
Yeah, sure.
The same, I started doing it with The Last of Us on the hardest difficulty setting, but it's...
That's hard.
It's really, like, you die if someone hit you once,
wow.
Pretty much. So it's really, really frustrating to play.
Yay, you know, the scarf. Scarf.
So
power.
My scarf is longer now. I'm guessing maybe I can get up there.
You're becoming the alpha male.
The alpha scarf.
Alpha scarf. Who...
No. All right. I'll go to my scarf friends here.
So Uncharted. Yeah, okay. I can see that.
I don't know if I've... Yeah, also Crash Bandicoot 3, when I played PlayStation 1. That one I did the whole time trial thing.
Oh!
I think it was really nice the way that... They had an extra level of gameplay for when you had just when you'd beaten the game, you could go back and play all the levels with a different focus.
Ah, interesting.
So you could get, I think it was a cross and a square. We had different challenges, get all the boxes and so on. I don't know what I'm doing, you know.
Constantine is writing, I still have nightmares of Last of Us where I had only a brick with me for half of the game. I think that sounds like, yeah, that sounds like the Last of Us.
Oh, yes.
I think most, like, when I'm thinking of newer games, I think games like Telltale, mm-hmm. their games are meant for replayability. Like, you can play it through and, like, experience different stories. But mm-hmm. I don't know why, but I don't want to do that. Because I feel like the first time I go through the story, that's kind of what I would do. Like, that's my playthrough. And going back, I would be
definitely.
Like, I'm not good at, like, doing that. Especially because nowadays we have, like, so many games and so little time, I feel like.
You get
2 games a month, 3, either if you're PlayStation or Xbox One. Like, and I think I don't even have time to play half of them.
I think this is the first time I'm playing a game since Uncharted 4 came out.
Yeah. So it's always about, like, which is why it's interesting when games are so catching, like, are able to I feel the same way, like, watching the same movie instead of watching something different. I feel mm-hmm. like I should experience something new, but still, like, you want to watch this movie again because it was very good, or you want to play this game again because
and
it
you
was
wanna
very fun.
And you want to get back into it, and you get the kind of nostalgia feeling
that
also is a very strong feeling when you play a game.
I think especially in games that doesn't necessarily need you to be super emotionally involved in, like,
invested.
I'm thinking, invested in like games like, I play a lot of, like, Gears of War or Halo, where it's like it's a simple gameplay, like you point and shoot.
Mm-hmm.
And you run around and that's what you do, and it's easy to pick up and play for like 30 minutes and put down again. Where especially like Telltale games or games like Journey or I would say The Last of Us, where story is, I know there's story in Halo and Mm-hmm. I guess Gears of War 2. It's not like that's not what the story is about, but
I agree.
Games
are either made out of from the premise of the gameplay experience or the story.
Usually, yeah.
Revolving around either or, right?
So it's not very often that you hit that point where like both of them come together so nicely. I think Last of Us is one of those instances.
Yeah.
But for me, it's usually those games I go back to and play. And like, instead of starting with a complete new, I've started playing The Witcher 2. Two or three times. Mm-hmm. I play the first 2 hours and then I forget about it.
Yeah.
Like, and I have to go back and like get into the gameplay again. Like,
yeah, I think I have the same problem with more open world games. I've also started Witcher 2 a couple of times and Witcher 3 as well a couple of times.
Yeah.
And I like you said, you get into the game, play it for a couple of hours in a straight, and then there might take a couple of weeks before you can get back into it, and you'll probably need to start over.
Exactly. Which I feel like, because often it's like feeling that you're missing out on something. Like, I should play this game. Like, The Witcher 3, I know people love it, and that, like, people have put so many hours into it, but I just can't get, like, I couldn't sit down and play that game, because I would have to invest so many hours, and still missing out on, like, a great experience is, like, it's difficult.
Mm-hmm.
It's a very first world gaming problem. Like,
oh, yes,
so many
sure.
good games that we can't play. Oh no!
But I mean, I think it takes a different attitude towards playing games, playing open world games. Mm. I think I haven't played through an open world game since Red Dead Redemption, which is also kind of it steers you towards certain points, so it's not completely open world.
No. We have another cutscene.
Oh, yes.
That means I can get some water.
No, so now we're going back down and the scarf snapped.
Oh, no.
Bonds are broken, literally.
Oh, wow, this looks...
Yeah, things are getting bleak now.
God damn.
Yeah, it's really...
That escalated quickly.
It's dark. So, it feels like these statues that we go to are remnants or memories from these white mother figures that we're meeting. I think these are turned into stone somehow. Okay. This is what I'm getting.
This definitely changed. A minute ago we were out in like the open.
Yeah, and fast paced and a lot of light, and now we're in this very cold desert, like in the night.
Yeah. Gives me the chills. Almost looks like snow.
Yeah,
maybe it is. No, I don't know.
But no, I think it's.
But it's probably sand.
I think we're still in the desert.
Yeah,
maybe. But yeah, the yellow and red color palette changed to.
Oh yeah.
White and blue. It's really, but it really works as well. This. And we have one of our friends here. Burp. Should I go inside this thing?
Ooh.
Where did they go? They moved on over here.
Oh, over there. Them little fishies.
Help
hey,
me.
Buddies.
Where am I going? Where am I going? Over there. Okay. Don't leave me. Oh, they're leading the way, I see. I like the way the scarf also shows your progression in the game.
Yeah.
I'm kind of starting to feel like a badass here.
Level up, bitch. You can take on anyone out there with a shorter scarf than you.
So we're gonna have to believe this if we're gonna monetize that video. Okay, here we have it. This is almost, it looks like it's underwater.
Yeah,
this is
it does.
Really, really cool.
So I would suggest maybe going to the left one there and then see if you can jump over to the other side. I mean, you're the player. I have no idea.
Let's see.
But after we missed that earlier one,
we don't want to miss more.
No.
It is underwater. I'm floating now.
Oh, what? Oh, that's because you were in the...
I was in the zone.
Oh, in those ones. So how you can... do you jump every time you push, or do you hold the button? I'm having
Sometimes when I use the circle button to do my call, things will come and lift me up, and okay. I'm not really doing anything here.
That's cool. Oh, there's another piece of scarf over there. I want to see like there's a guy just like with a scarf like half a kilometer long, just like walking around like carrying everything like, oh, somebody please take this off me.
So I was wondering if you need to have a certain length in order to move on or complete the game, because in the beginning I think the only time that I had to have a long scarf was to actually get more scarf.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's like you could maybe complete it without getting a big scarf.
And really changed to the, like, this underwater kind of
setting. Yeah, things look very floaty now. And I think I can use the call to climb this. Or at least get charged.
Ah, yeah, so you've... Oh, wow, what are those?
Oh, gobbles. What are they?
What on earth is that? Hey, buddy.
Oh, no!
Oh! Help us! Help us! Thank you. That was close.
Oh, I can stand on it. I see.
Oh, thank God. Breathe. Whew, that almost went wrong. Oh, yeah, so what I didn't tell you is this is permadeath, by the way. If you die, you have to start the game over.
No!
I don't even, like...
Don't make me worry like that. It would... I don't know if... I guess it's short enough, but it would probably kill the the experience for the gamer. I think I did something wrong here, yeah. Okay. We're on the bottom.
We hit rock bottom. Oh, these mechanical sounds?
Yeah, I think we're getting closer to something with civilization, or at least somewhere that used to be. Yeah, we have electric lights here as well. Or something. I see something in the distance. I'll give it my best jump here.
Oh, I got those like little beacons. It's like bleep, yeah. Bleep, bleep, follow me.
Oh! What the hell? Wah!
Oh, what the fuck was that?
That's okay, so I'm pretty sure we have an evil stone people coming after us.
All right, I was not prepared for that. Yeah.
And the game audio is really loud in the headset, so that was a shock. Rip headphone users.
What just happened?
Our carpet friend died. He was eaten by a rock snake.
God.
Onyx came by.
Dang. Oh.
Yeah, so now we know what the stakes are here. Big, red, and juicy. So sometimes I don't even have to turn around the corners. I just move forward and he will turn for me. I think that's kind of weird. Okay, no, he's gonna eat them.
Okay, so yeah, they're definitely. Yes.
Oh,
looks
man.
Looks like he is like looking for you, so.
I should probably stay out of his spotlight.
I think that would be a good idea.
But he is gone. I can't see him.
And then all of a sudden we die again from a heart attack, and she's like pops out of the floor.
So it's kind of weird. This section is really not that fast paced, I don't know.
Watch out. Run away.
I'm wondering what would happen if I was caught. Because so far we haven't had to reset anything. Should I stay out of the light?
I'm so like...
Yeah, it's really so getting tense. Intense.
Okay, those look like places to hide.
Yeah.
Or maybe not.
Maybe I should stay in here until he passes by again.
So.
I had no idea it was gonna go this place. I get this tense.
Can you just like run back like out into the sun again?
Yeah, I'd like that.
Oh no. Oh. Okay. So that's definitely one on the left there. So yeah. Watch out. Maybe go behind it. Was that? Oh, you did that before, right? I think that was.
Yeah, I'm not gonna go in front of it.
Nope.
I'm getting the feeling that they have triggers timing this, so we get the feeling that we were close to get caught, but we really weren't. Because that was way too close for it to be, like, just luck.
God damn. Oh my god, Nils.
Should I hide behind the pillar? Maybe. Stay out of the light is what they all say.
Can you look behind you? I'm scared. See, like, all right, looks good. Is that one right there?
I don't know. He didn't do anything. If it was, I see the light though.
Before I was like, I like the light. Now I'm like, shit. I don't like. Oh.
What? Okay. I can't do anything here, can I?
Run away!
Shit!
Oh, fuck! Oh, sweet Jesus!
I can't do anything! I'm trying to...
Get away! I thought you were done for.
That was really intense.
Because you were, like, chased by one, and then the other one found you as well. It was like...
Oh man!
Oh my god!
Good to find the safe place.
Yo, please have another cutscene. I need a breather. Ooh! Yeah, that was too close, mate.
Okay. So, I need to. Oh, what's going on?
Move into the light.
Yeah. Wow, yeah.
I feel almost dizzy from that.
Oh yeah, my like my hands are tingling right now.
What do you think of the music so far? No, it's like there's some score, but
it's you know, it's the kind of atmospheric kind of music that I really enjoy listening to when I go to bed. I really like to sleep listening to the soundtracks of The Revenant, and also actually The Last of Us has an excellent soundtrack that I really really enjoy, and I can imagine going home and listen to this soundtrack.
I'm checking out the story here, because like, so there was a Kickstarter earlier this year, January, for doing like a Journey Live like concert tour.
Oh.
I think. Ooh, oh wow! You got a trophy.
Did we go through it now? Maybe.
You got a trophy. No, we're still going.
Okay.
So a Kickstarter where they wanted to do. They wanted to play the music live while playing the game. So Sony has given them like a version of the game that disables the music, and then an orchestra will be like performing it while a player is playing it. Like,
I think that's a really cool idea.
Yeah. So, and the Kickstarter got funded and everything.
Yeah.
So it's, I'll check up on this while you keep playing.
So we found a friend here. And we confirmed the theory that you could go through it with a shorter scarf. I'm feeling pretty good about myself right now.
Hey, how are you doing, man? Hey. You only have that one.
I'm like a senior scarf manager.
Look at us.
Where did he go?
Oh wow, so they just had an update yesterday. They'll bring it to Calgary. AB, now I need to know my US state reference. That was at Alabama, maybe? So yeah, it got $52,505 granted. And it was originally going for just $9,000 to do like a 4-city tour. So
yeah.
It's coming to a lot of different cities. It's going to... Can I see that somewhere?
Right. I don't like this. Oh, I see.
Oh, sorry, that's in Alberta, Canada, not Alabama.
Yeah, that's kind of the opposite.
Sweet home Alberta. Yeah, so I thought it was pretty cool, like to have and imagine being that player, having like an orchestra perform next to you playing a video game.
Oh yeah!
Like right now, there are like 70, 80 people sitting around you with violins and like looking at you playing. Like,
I'm wondering what the ticket for playing would be.
I think that's really cool, and the soundtrack is absolutely incredible.
Mm-hmm.
They even released a 2-record vinyl version. That's good for you. Oh, you like vinyls as well.
Yeah, I'm gonna have to get a hold of that. Yeah, I've actually... there are some soundtracks I would like to have on vinyl. Yeah, for those of you who don't know, we also have a vinyl show on Modem.
Yeah, great plug.
Yeah. So sometime later this semester, you will probably see me and hear me and Sandra and Carl talk about vinyls.
So go follow our Facebook page, give us a like, subscribe.
Yeah,
that's how YouTubers do it.
Do the plug thing.
No, but if you want to see more, you know, go find us on Facebook. I'm sure this is not the last time we'll be doing this.
Yeah.
But we'll get back to that once we've hopefully completed the game.
Yeah.
Which will be like tomorrow morning, like.
Yeah, we'll play all night.
Yeah. Yeah, the next time we'll go to Grand Theft Auto 4.
We'll go through the entire series. We'll start by one.
Like.
Did you play I think I played the second Grand Theft Auto. That was pretty cool. Like the top down one. Yeah.
The game changed so much when it went into like 3D space.
Yeah, I remember trying out Grand Theft Auto 3 and I was thinking, what the hell is this?
You can actually play the first two now online for free.
Really?
They put it up on Rockstar's website. You can just go download it. It's pretty cool.
Hmm. Nostalgia trip.
This is like a crazy dragon.
Yeah, this is, I think, this is the kind of thing that went after us before, but it had been turned to stone.
Yeah.
So it's like they've been... Oh, there's something I should get in there. I'm gonna leave this guy behind.
See you, pal! That reminded me of, like, Shadow of the Colossus, which is, like, one of those games that I have played so many times. Because there are only 16 enemies in the game, like, they're just, like, bosses. So yeah. Once you go through, it's, like, time travels... Time, getting through as quick as possible. And they have this... incredible and also annoying new game plus feature where like you get more and more stamina the more you play, so you have to complete it like 3 times to like get full stamina, and then you can like climb this thing in the middle, this tower in the middle, which you can't climb unless you like
gotten so they force you to repeat game segments to be able to progress.
Well, like you complete the game and then like you can decide, okay, now I want to play again, but okay, you have the same amount of stamina as you had when you finished the game, and it's just an Easter egg. But if you want to go see the Easter egg, you have to like complete it 3 times.
Okay.
Then you can do like time travels and hard mode to get like extra, like explosive arrows and stuff, like kind of crazy things. But damn, I played that game so many times. Super good. Absolutely incredible too.
So what did this do? Oh, a bridge was made. The bond was mended, is what I'm thinking.
Ah.
Let's go ahead and see. It's got this kind of oriental vibe to the music.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. Right, it turned all like...
Yeah, with this kind of, not steel drum, but I don't know what it's called.
Yeah, like cymbals and like small percussion.
Yeah, and the flute, of course, is the big giveaway here. Oh. Lift me, pals. Thank you.
Lift me, pals. Lift me.
Scarves lift us up where we belong.
Oh, wow, this is so cool. Yeah. So you just climb from the bottom of the tower, right?
It's kind of like every time I do this, everything goes down.
Oh.
It looks like, so I'm not really moving up.
Oh.
Or I'm not quite sure. Or maybe it's just this yellow thing that makes sure that I can keep on jumping while I'm underneath this. It's just so that I won't fall down, I guess.
Oh, that's cool. Wow.
Oh, we're at the the first time my controller is vibrating is happening now when I'm seeing these guys. This is weird. Oh.
Final one?
Yeah.
There we go. Oh, yes. Another cutscene.
But this time it's not a cartoon cutscene.
Do we have a name for this guy?
Scarfy?
Scarfy. Okay, I was gonna go with Nils, so... Nils the Scarfy. Nils Scarfy. Maybe Nils, that's good. Nils Scarfy.
Or Scarface.
Scarface.
Scarface,
yeah.
Okay.
Scarface.
Oh, she said something this time. I don't know why I'm thinking it's a she.
It does look like a mother figure.
Yeah.
So, Mother Mary. This is actually just an interpretation of the Bible.
Yeah.
Your Jesus.
This is the entire picture from our journey.
Oh, wow.
I think.
Oh, yeah, because that's what you did. Oh, those were, like, the scary monsters.
Yeah, yeah.
And then you went up through the... Yeah, 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 yeah. And now you're
the
there.
The wind. I see. But it's actually quite weird the journey was written in stone before I came there. Are we talking about deterministic kind of world view here, or?
That's computer ethics. You have to discuss that, Miguel.
I'm not gonna go into it, but I was just, it's weird that it was carved in stone while we were doing it.
Oh yeah.
Unless it's because we're kind of making our own path.
Sure.
But I'm thinking we're probably getting to the top of the...
Definitely snow. Sand does not fall that slow.
Unless it's the underwater kind of thing. Let's speed up a bit here.
Okay.
Yeah, this is snow.
Good, because then I can tell you about another sound effect, because I didn't want to say it until we reached this point. So for like walking in the snow, they used like Fritos and Cheetos and like different snacks, like cracking them, like a mixture of all that. I think that was like such a funny thing as well. This is like
Cheetos.
Yeah.
Oh, wow. That's a long way.
I'm also getting the vibrations now that I'm walking. It's weird when they choose to use this.
Ah, oh, it looks so good.
Oh, should I go up there to see this thing first? I'm thinking of Aladdin where the carpet is frozen.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, guys.
In the, when Aladdin has been banished.
Oh, yeah.
By Jafar.
I hear you.
Hmm, and the snow is settling on the scarf. I think I'm at a point where...
Oh no, not those guys again.
I think I'm at a point where I did the thing we talked about earlier, where I moved on from something that I should have interacted with.
Because
so there was this...
Try that. You definitely... I don't know. I mean, and you have a long scarf now. Oh wow, it's like super snowy.
Yeah.
And frozen.
Oh, it's gone the other thing now.
Or maybe that was the one? Cause
oh, they don't thaw when I do this. I thought it's just... Okay, so
yeah, yeah.
I see you have to keep it thawed to...
if you want to use
recharge
it.
Recharge your scarf power.
Oh yeah, because then like your scarf is freezing now. So it's like...
Mm-hmm.
Ah, interesting. But like, you definitely... Even though you have a long scarf, you definitely get that feeling of like... being powerless to these things.
Oh yeah.
Like you can run and you can hide, but that's it. Like you can't fight them, you know?
Mm-hmm.
Like which is like why horror games, like that's their like main
I guess
thing for making things scary right now, like Outlast and
yeah, you can't do anything about
like
it.
Like Amnesia, it's like
Alien Isolation.
Yeah. It's like or you could just punch like, oh I can do that. Let's do that.
Yeah, we'll pull out the big machine gun.
Yeah, which is, I guess, why, like, usually in games like Fallout, where your character starts off, like, really weak, it's like, I don't want to go in here because I don't know what it is. And then later on, it's like, oh, bring it on. Yeah. I can do whatever I want.
Okay, now it's getting windy.
Oh, this does not look comfortable. This looks like Denmark at the moment.
No. Oh.
This will be Denmark in a few months.
God. Yeah, no, not even in a few months. By the rate things are going now, it was 9 degrees today, and it's like 3 weeks ago, it was 30.
It's freezing.
So
I hate
if we
it.
Drop 20 degrees
what
every
happened?
Other week, we'll be dead by the end of the semester.
Literally, last week I was wearing shorts.
Yeah.
Literally, last week. I'm like, what the hell? It's freezingly cold all of a sudden. God,
I don't know what these things are. I'm just moving.
Maybe
past
they're shelter for you to hide behind from the. Wind.
Yeah, now I can't really do anything here.
Maybe you have like when the wind comes, you have to like stand behind them. Oh,
yeah.
It looks so cool with the snow. I love that.
Oh no! Oh yeah, it keeps me from not moving. Maybe I should stand behind it. I don't know.
Christopher is asking how long the game is. We're thinking it's roughly 1.5 to 2 hours, I think.
Yeah, that's what at least what other playthroughs has looked
yeah,
like there.
So
how far in are we now?
I think we're almost done.
How much time have we been streaming?
An hour and a half.
Okay.
So,
No!
It depends on how quick we are.
Yeah.
I honestly can't remember, like, how far it is.
No, but
like,
I mean, we're moving up the mountain now.
Yeah,
with
sure.
Which I'm guessing is the... I mean, we don't know for sure, but that's what they've communicated,
yes.
I think, through the...
And, like, it's definitely, like, a linear game in that way, so...
Mm-hmm.
It's not like we're doing side quests. We actually did, like...
Well, a bit.
When you started the game, if you go right, you do, like, a whole, like, 7-hour side quest loop, and if you go straight, you do, like, the main story, which in an hour and a half, we just didn't know. All right, Nils, now, go for it, go! Run, you... Run, Scarfy, you mother... Something?
Yeah. Something, oh. Something.
Man, this looks really cold as well.
Mm-hmm.
Giving the shivers...
Oh, no.
Hide behind it. Hide.
It's really difficult
yeah,
to control
definitely,
it.
Yeah, you definitely have to stand behind those when, like, the wind.
Maybe I should just stay here until the next time the wind has blown over.
Yeah, okay. I was going to say go for it.
I'll go for it then.
I love how we waited and then, like, oh, yeah.
Yeah, no, it was pretty stupid decision.
Run back and then behind it. There we go. Oh, it was perfect. I mean,
yeah,
I
meant to do
it
that.
It was on purpose. Of course it was. Yeah. All right, go for it. Run, Scarfy, you goddamn son of a scarf. Blank, or a carpet, I guess.
I can feel the frustration from moving this slow because of the headwind.
Yeah.
Like my thumb is starting to hurt because I pressed the button so hard because I want to move forward.
Go. Oh, there's nothing
I
to
can't do in. This with these.
Let's hope there's no bin here.
Oh, I can play the cello.
Are you playing a symphony for us? Yeah. Oh, there's something over there.
Wake up. Take me somewhere. No.
I almost heard like the baseball, like the charge, like.
I can see that. Should I move up here?
Yes. To the moon, Alice. If that is the moon, I have no idea. Looks like.
I think that's the moon. Moon. We're just gonna ignore that one, aren't we?
Not the stone dragons.
Oh, did we just see another player up there? I think I saw something at least. Pulsating.
And then the like enemy, like the big dragon just comes down and eats him. Like, oh.
And it fries your hardware.
It has kind of like Dark Souls, Demon Souls vibe to it with like, you can't really say much, but you can like leave tracks.
Mm-hmm.
Like, saying like, he can like bleep and like show you, but. It's interesting.
To me, it's kind of playing with different settings that I feel like this I've seen before in Uncharted 2. moving through a snowstorm.
Yeah.
I guess other games has done it as well, but this is just what I'm being reminded of.
Oh, hey, buddy. Oh, that's all you have? That's your scarf? Please.
Yeah.
I mean, this is what you want. This is what impressed the ladies.
Yeah, that's what.
And then he like runs away from you, like, get away from me.
Yeah, he's embarrassed.
Like, oh, I don't want it anymore.
Oh, we actually kind of need each other here.
Oh yeah,
this is cool. I'm wondering if it's even a real player.
Can you hit that thing up? Yeah.
Oh okay, I don't need him then.
Maybe that's good, because then you can just jump on and like run.
Yeah.
Unless he like fucks you over.
I won't care about him.
Oh, okay, he made it. I was like, it would be good if you just like made it drop in front of him. Like, what?
Fall all the way down.
My friend. Like, get a bigger scarf. Moron.
Okay, headwind again.
Oh no. More snow.
Something lighting up the lines there. I don't know if some people.
That's gonna be all ITU students. Coming from Deabun, like in January or like February, that's gonna be what's
just
like massive win, just like.
So now is the time to invest in ponchos.
Yeah. And long scarves.
Yeah.
Which is perfect because I just brought a great selection of scarves from my home here. We have a lovely
we're
green.
We're sponsored by.
ITU scarves. Buy your scarves now. 5% off if you use the promo code Modem. At www, this is a fake website for buyingscarves.com.
We should make that.
We should. Every time you just say a fake website, you should just register your URL just to have it. Mm-hmm. And just have them like
shit,
redirect.
Shit.
Yep, he got the other guy. Don't worry. He's.
What?
Well, that's not our problem.
Sweet Jesus. Did he die?
Go check him? Go check him in. Okay, he just got punched really hard.
Oh,
how are you doing, buddy?
So sad.
Did he lose some of his scarf?
I think so.
Maybe that's what happened to the other players. That's why we have such a long scarf.
Because I was superior at moving past these onyxes.
Stick to him. That was a good plan. You were like right next to each other, and as soon as the guy like,
yeah,
dragon spider, he's like,
I'm into
see you,
that.
Bye.
Not helping.
Every man to themselves.
Yeah, and now it's coming again, taking him. I hope. Mm. I think I'll get on the leaderboard for having the biggest scarf completing this game.
That would be an interesting thing.
Okay, bad idea jumping. Get caught in the wind.
You two walk together, yes! Use the power of friendship.
We're warming each other like penguins.
Use the power of friendship, Neil.
Use the force, Harry.
This does look like, is it Hoth? Like
yeah,
where
yeah.
Luke fights his lightsaber?
Luke, yeah.
That's the only thing I know from Star Wars, by the way.
Really?
That and sand people, sand people. That's all I know. Speaking of Star Wars, you know what? They are going to add Star Wars Battlefront to the vault. Which is on Xbox One, you can get like an EA subscription service where you get access to games.
Mm-hmm.
They're gonna add Star Wars Battlefront, which means
awesome. You'll be playing it.
I'll be playing it and learning about Star Wars.
Nice.
Yay.
See, what you should do is there's this thing called movies.
Movie? Is
yeah,
that like a cow thing?
Yeah, you should. No. It's like moving pictures.
What?
You should try to watch these movies. They're pretty awesome. Everyone likes them except Miguel.
So, are there Star Wars movies?
Oh yes, for sure. There are like seven of them.
So they're based on the real, like what in real life what happened.
Oh yeah, long time ago, in a galaxy far, far away.
Yeah. Oh, I thought that was just like only history books and like, oh wow.
Mm-hmm.
I'm gonna go home and watch one of those then.
No, but in all seriousness, they're definitely worth watching.
Yeah. To be honest, I think I have seen them, like number 4, 5, and 6.
Yeah,
but I could not tell you a single thing about the movies.
Those are the ones you want watch at least.
And I did watch the newest one.
Oh,
that was pretty good. run away!
No.
Oh, hide! Run! Do something! Oh!
No!
I was gonna say we made it, but
I should have moved away. I didn't realize that he was.
God.
I thought
dang.
If I was out of the light, he wouldn't get me.
Nils, that cost you a lot of the scarf.
Yeah, and also this. I have these rubber thumb grips on there. I was trying to move too hard.
God, that looked brutal. Look how much of your scarf.
Oh no, he's coming back.
Oh no, not again. Nils, run, jump, do something.
Okay, I guess I can't avoid this.
Oh my. Oh yeah.
What are people saying?
Christopher is asking us to do Firewatch next time. That'll be
cool.
I like that game.
So the thing is, we've both played that one, but I would really want to play it again. I think there's a lot of replayability in that game.
Yeah.
And I think it's a really, really awesome game. Great suggestion.
Oh yes.
And it really segues nicely into what I guess we're gonna talk about after we're done. If you guys, the listeners, want us to do this again.
Yeah.
Because this is kind of an experiment.
Definitely. This is the first time we're doing it.
Yeah.
Which is why it's so, like, incredible hot in here, because we're in one of the skyboxes attached to you.
Oh, shit.
Hell,
the TV is going to turn off in activity. Maybe I should just stand still while you handle this. I don't know. We'll keep on moving. Sebastian is just looking at what's going on here.
Okay, I think I did something with the sound. How did we turn off the sound before?
Yes. Yeah, I think you solved the problem, hopefully.
Oh, wait. When you put your headphones in the PlayStation, does it stop?
Does it what?
When you put your headphones in the PlayStation controller, does it stop putting it on the television?
Yeah.
Nice.
So Sebastian asked if you plug in headphones into the controller, will it remove this audio from the TV? And it will. I think it's for the teenage room. So they damn. Okay, the operation is still saying that it's going to turn off the TV. So I guess we should just wait and Sebastian will turn off and on the TV.
Is that what I will do? Let's hope nothing happens to the stream. Too late. I'm going to do it now.
Yeah. Just give us a second, guys.
HDMI. Otherwise, things are actually working pretty well. Surprisingly.
We can't really hear you when you're not in front of a microphone.
Sorry.
I'm gonna jinx it. I just said that things were actually working pretty well.
Yeah, so, until now.
Until now, but
we are so close. We can't stop now, but that we're not getting a picture on the.
Is the television not on? Hold on. Oh my god.
Bear with us, guys. We're having technical difficulties here. I think Sebastian is fixing it now. We're praying to the IT gods. Yeah. Okay. I got the. I can see again. Sorry about that, guys.
We're back.
Gals. Yes.
Ooh. All right. Back in action.
I'm not totally sure what I'm supposed to do, and the guy I was following is gone.
He's like, "What are these idiots doing?"
I'm gonna climb the scarf. I like this way of thinking about the game mechanics, that you can use the same thing for a lot of different challenges.
I mean, when you think about like your controls, what are they? You have jump and shout and move around. That's it. Like that's incredible.
They really make a lot of out of not a lot of controls.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Like that's usually what happens. Like game developers, they see like, oh, I have 17 different buttons on the controller I can use. Let's have this do this, this do this, this do this, like 16 different things.
I think limiting yourself is definitely a great way of being able to be more creative.
At least in games that are, I don't want to say that journey is minimalistic, but games that are less, at least complicated.
Yeah.
Like hardcore RPGs like The Witcher and Elder Scrolls and stuff, it's good to have many abilities, but like I think that's the beauty sometimes with hack and slash, is it's just the combination of buttons you push. You have three buttons and the combination of pushing those creates like,
like the way this game plays, we could actually put Kratos here and it would be God of War, right?
Yeah.
And then add all of the button things to interact with.
Yeah.
But so it really changes just by removing the options of having more interactions with buttons.
Yeah. Because that's what you have. Like you have a jump button and then the sound, which I guess is the interact kind of thingy. Get safe.
Yeah, I think this is where I'm supposed to hide.
I think
so now, by now we're getting used to the different kinds of challenges they present us with.
Okay.
So here we need to
hide. You can't stop on the next two though, so...
Oh,
run! Run, damn it! Run, Nils! Run, Scarfy!
This is not gonna work.
Yes, it will. Yes, it will!
No. No, 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 no!
No, it won't!
Did we just...
Oh, okay.
Oh, so we can be held by fire. I thought we just died for the first time, but this is evidently not a game that will kill you. All right.
And we lost a lot of the scarf, right?
Yeah, we were almost out of scarf.
No, not the scarf.
I was hoping that we could be like really impressively going through this. But
are you into like trophies and stuff?
I don't have any platinum trophies.
Okay, you don't care about it that much. I was gonna see, because maybe there was a like going through the game finding all the extra scarves and not lose a single one, and I was gonna destroy you, but I don't think there is, so it's alright.
Yeah, I'm pretty sure there might be, but let's just focus on trying to get through this. And I'm not really, this is not working for me.
Are you using your shout?
Yeah, but I think there's something with the depth of the screen that the when I try to go close to the wall here,
there you go.
Doesn't matter. I won't explain.
We just have to talk about it. It's actually what you don't know is it's also like audio based, so you have to tell the.
Is this where we came from?
No, this is where we need to go, I think, because we came from the left.
Oh, okay. So it won't even force us to.
No, no.
Okay.
Thank God.
I like that. So it just gave us the easy path.
Sure. Wow.
We're still not up there. And now the rest of the scarf is gone. And there's another player. I think this... We're... I'm thinking Lord of the Rings here.
Well, there was another guy, right? So...
Yeah.
In case we need to go to cannibalism, at least we have someone to eat. So that's good. We have to stay warm.
Meat's back on the menu, boys.
And now this guy's like, no, I'm a vegetarian.
Yeah. This is getting really, really intense again.
Just so you're aware, the sound that people hear is not as like, they definitely okay. hear our voices. It's not as, cause like the music is really loud in our ears.
Okay. Right?
So
yeah,
no worries.
I'm almost sweating because yeah. of the loud sound here.
Thunder.
Oh, are we three people here or is it just, oh, it's just a...
That's another one to eat if, yeah. if you want to.
I think we are three now. Oh, can wow. that happen?
Maybe. There's at least one in front of you.
That okay, guy. It's still just pieces of
okay,
statues.
It's like, yeah. We're so close. Maybe. I have no idea.
I'm getting the feeling that we'll be...
This seems like the last like walk, right?
Yeah, the final stretch.
Like, have you played Far Cry 4?
No, I haven't.
Okay, but when you get to the end, there's also like you have to make a decision, and like mm-hmm. there's this long road that you're driving on for like 2.5 minutes where you're just driving. Like, and Far Cry, it's a shooter, so it's like you know, like, oh, something's coming up.
Okay, now the sound is all gone, so I'm feeling like this is the eye of the hurricane, or what is it called?
He's so slow. Come on, buddy. You
I
can
think
do
things
it.
Are gonna explode
Come on,
in
buddy.
Just a second.
Come on, buddy. Oh no. Come on.
Yeah, this is definitely his final effort.
Oh my. No, no.
Did he just collapse?
No, no.
No. Scarfy.
No, come on. You can do it, man. Come on.
Don't turn into a rock.
All right, and that's the end of the stream. Thank you guys for watching.
We can't end it on this note.
It's the end of the game, Nils.
We need a happy ending.
It's the end of a game.
And then what they had children, and everything was fun.
Come on, Scarfy. If credits start rolling now, we're going to be like, what the?
Okay, we have some helpers here.
Ooh. Oh, all the mothers. Did we have 6 cutscenes?
Oh, I don't recall. Okay. Might have.
You can do it, man. Come on. There you go. There you go. Stand up tall.
Oh, and Whoa. The scarf is back. All right.
Oh, wow. What a scarf.
Yeah. That's a guy with a scarf.
And now he gets superpowers.
Oh, yeah, you're right.
And that was... Oh, wow. That was just a guess. This is the birth of Master
Whoa.
Chief. Are you controlling?
No, I'm doing nothing. Oh, I can't do...
Oh, okay.
I guess I should steer out clear of these.
Maybe.
Nice. I think we're getting there now.
Oh, wow. It's beautiful.
See, here the colors are almost like Firewatch.
Yeah. Oh, wow.
Oh, this is so cool.
Oh, my. And that super scarf activated.
Oh, yes.
Oh, this is such a pretty game.
Yeah.
And this was done by a 16-man team, which a lot of them, I'm sure, worked on,
yeah,
on like
graphics.
Audio, on graphics. But like... As part of like programming as well, but like all this is so incredibly, and like you have like if you look around, you can see far, far away. I mean, yeah. this
oh,
is.
Oh shit! I shouldn't.
Oh, sorry. I'm gonna ruin the game now. But like in earlier in the desert, like you could see like a long distance.
Yeah. Oh,
the skybox is freaking amazing. This is such a well done game.
And now we're getting some more triumphant music. I feel like we're getting to the end now. Okay, oh, and all our friends are here.
Yay! Fishies! just bump your head and pass out in the snow, just like...
The end.
Yeah.
Oh, maybe I can make it to the dragon thing.
Oh. Oh, wow. Oh, I guess you're going up.
Up, 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 over the mountaintop. Yeah, now things are really picking up pace. Are we there yet? Is this it? It sounds like the ending of a Japanese cartoon. Jellyfish. Yeah, this has been an incredible journey.
I see what you did there.
Wow. You're
almost there, Niels.
And my scarf is so huge. I have the best scarves in the world.
You do. You earned that scarf, man.
No one has better scarves than I do.
Fly, Scarfy. You can do it. Fucking amazing, man.
Wow, the music is really emotional.
Tissues? I have tissues.
I'm okay. I'm not crying just yet.
Hold on. There we go.
Thank you.
Just in case, Nils, we have them right here.
Now the scarf is gone.
Oh. God dang. I just want a picture of this on my wall.
Yeah, it's really, really pretty. This is the kind of game where almost everything could be turned into a poster.
Yeah, definitely. Especially if our two faces are up in the right corner.
Yeah.
Oh, we can do a little like... Hold up, I can do this like... Goodbye, Scarfy. Goodbye. See you. Does that work?
Oh, yes. Viewers can tell us if there are any viewers.
I can see here.
Okay, pay attention up here now, I think, Sebastian.
Oh, yeah, sorry.
I think we're getting there.
I want that as my screensaver. I want that as my screensaver. I want that as my screensaver.
Oh yeah, I'm really feeling the soundtrack. It's really beautiful. Is he hesitating now? He's walking slower. Pure white. Interesting. Oh, okay, now that he's moving into the horizon. So did he just go home? Or is
that's
he
a different
anyone? Gone home, right? We can play Gone Home as well.
Oh yeah, that's a good one too. Very story driven though.
Yeah, but I think we might be okay with that, those kind of games.
Yep.
Okay, let's see what happens here. If anything. Is it just gonna roll the credits now or no?
I honestly have no idea.
More. Bonus level.
This is the ending of Journey. So if you just joined, spoiler alert.
Did someone just write something?
Someone just wrote, hola.
Hola.
¿Cómo días?
¿Cómo estás?
Yeah, I know, no Spanish.
Okay, we're done. And he's the star taking off.
Oh, you're going through. This is where we've been.
That was really, really cool.
Wow. All right, should we just talk a little bit about the game while the credits are rolling?
Sure.
Like, because this was your first time playing it.
It was, and I can see myself playing this again.
Yeah. I mean, it's definitely a different setting to be in here with me in your ears all the time, but like going through and like hearing all the music and experience it. What did you think of it? First of all,
I'm really, really impressed. And I mean, I knew this was going to be great. I've heard so many great things about it, but I think the score, the soundtrack was really, really, it was supporting this mood and the story really, really well. And we also had just astonishing visuals and a subtle way of telling the story. And everything was very subtle, but at the same time,
yeah.
I think it's really, really well pulled off.
Cool.
I mean, I don't really know what just happened. We can just, I mean, it seems like we had this lost civilization scarf people, and they kind of lost to this rock kind of people. And some of the scarves were left behind in the desert, and he was saving those. But in the end, he moved out. And just, I mean, the ending here, he left the mountain on his own. I don't know. Oh, I see now. He's going back through the settings and reviving everything, bringing back life. And okay, I was thinking that was really weird, selfish way of ending. No, I see. So we are the savior of the lost scarf people.
Yeah, wow, I'm impressed how much of it you caught. I don't want to, like, go through Wikipedia and stuff, because maybe you'll play it again and you'll catch up some more, but you actually got a lot, like, of the story about, like, an ancient, like, all the ruins and ancient civilizations, mm-hmm. and, like, which, I mean, I didn't follow, like, I watched someone play through it.
I mean, we see the buildings, and
so... But you, I mean, I just... And when you think about this, there hasn't been a single word, not a single, like... line,
yeah,
of text, nothing,
just the button saying start in the beginning, yeah, and that was it.
That's it, begin your journey, and yeah, from that you've gathered all this.
That's a really, really tough challenge to tackle, communicating an entire game without actually writing anything. We failed miserably at that when we made our bachelor's project.
Yeah,
we thought we could just do this cool game and write nothing and the player would figure out everything, and when we play tested, nobody had any clue of what was going on.
Definitely. The only hint you had was sometimes like the control schemes would show you what to do this, but that's it.
It was actually kind of weird. The first part where I was supposed to tilt to change the camera angle. I don't know if I could do that throughout the entire game, but I never used it after the beginning. So it was kind of a weird thing to introduce.
So,
should I try to see if I can turn down the volume here a bit?
No, it's okay. I can hear you. I'm not like...
Okay, I can also just...
Yeah, if you want.
Guys, it's really, really loud in the speaker headphones. All right.
And what? We're back to...
where we started.
You're back where you started. Funny enough, the title screen.
Wonder where he came from. Companions met along the way.
Ah,
reborn.
So these were the players that I met.
Oh, this is really, really cool.
We even met
Goku.
4, 5. Wow.
And do we get different icons?
Perhaps.
I didn't realize we met that many people.
No, 5 people. That's a lot.
I think this is so cool, including this in the end. Awesome.
Yeah, I'm glad that like a game company this size, like that game company, like there were 16 people for there were less beforehand, but because they teamed up with Sony, Sony Computer Entertainment of America, like they actually get to do, to make stuff that they want to make. Like they, yeah. they want to have a, an orchestral score that's amazing to fit with the game, and you can't do that. I mean, even if you're eight people on a team who all knows how to play the clarinet, it's yeah, gonna be difficult, you know.
You need
like,
to hire an
it gives you access for a small team of very passionate people to go ahead and bring out ideas and figure out what kind of game do we want to make. And the lead guy, Genova Chen, who's been like the director through the entire game, he's been on like pretty much every single thing of it, like from creating like the story to figuring out the art style to choosing what sound should be implemented. He was like himself in there and like making sure that things were implemented how they should be, which is incredible. And for me, like the past two games, like Flow and Flower, are also games that are like so simple to pick up and like something you like. It's an experience you go through, and I feel like Journey the same way is very, very much like that.
It was a journey.
It was a journey. Mm-hmm. Great journey. A great journey, you would say?
We keep on doing these puns. We'll see, at one point, if anyone writes, please stop. Yeah.
Yeah, this was incredible. I'm glad I saw this again, because it's been so long since I last walked through the game and I couldn't remember it.
I'm wondering how I actually made it through this much time without ever playing it. Oh, see you.
Oh, yeah, yeah.
Goodbye.
Buen juego. Adios. Goodbye, Madame Suck. Don't know who that is. Yeah, it's actually quite impressive. So did you have you seen a little bit of the, like the gameplay beforehand, or was it completely
well,
new?
I guess I've seen like an IGN review, so I've seen this setting of a person running around in the desert, and I also knew about that there could show other players could show up, but I hadn't seen this the dark setting and the water setting and the snow setting, all of that I'd never seen before, and also didn't know what was going to happen with these pieces of scarves. And like you saw in the beginning of the stream, if you were around, you viewers here, the first time I came by these pieces of scarves, I thought I was supposed to pick it up. And so I spent a lot of time trying to figure out what I was supposed to do. So a helpful view of road that it was just charging my scarf. So thank you for that.
Yeah, that would have been a long game if we didn't know that. That's cool. Is there anything else like we want to go through? I feel like this is something that you can take home and like sit down and reminisce about and like write like pages and pages, but anything here? Because otherwise I think we should figure out like what's the next step for this. This is the first time we've been doing this.
Yeah.
We feel like is appropriate. I think it went pretty well.
Yeah, me too.
I'm very happy about the technical setups. It helps a lot just doing it on the PlayStation.
Yeah, compared to a PC, which will be like chugging along.
That.
And,
But no, I think it went well. Like we've been doing this for about almost 2 hours now, minus the 8 minutes. Minutes. So like, and what we talked about, like right now we picked a game that was actually something you can complete from the start to the finish.
Yeah.
That doesn't necessarily have to be it. It's a good time span, but you know, like, what I'm thinking, like games that are longer, you could just play for however long you want.
Yeah.
If you want to do multiplayer games, talk about something specific.
Yeah, yeah. So it really depends on if it's story driven and if it's like a 12-hour game, then we would have to do game segments or pieces, and like, I don't know if that's possible.
No.
So probably maybe a Rocket League or whatever, where you can sit down and play against other players and then have fun.
Maybe.
I think that could work. Or also, like Firewatch was suggested. I think that would be really cool as well. It's a bit. It takes a bit more, a few more hours than. Than this.
I think it's around three and a half, maybe four. But yeah, because this idea was originally that because we have like the other people on Modem talking about the Ray games and like news and other things, but we wanted to make kind of a book club, but with video games. Like sit down and have one video game that either all the hosts played beforehand, or in this case, we could actually play the entire game throughout the stream.
Yeah, so at first we talked about just sitting down and talking about games we both played before, like a book club, but then we realized we wanted to include you guys, the viewers, so we figured this was a better way for you to come along on for the journey.
So we'll try to figure out a way to do that if we're going to do longer games in the future, or I think at least we're going to try... to make something that's at least has some focus on this game, like why we chose this game.
Mm.
Like a game of Call of Duty would be fun to play for an hour and a half, 2 hours and talk, but we need like some sort of theme, I guess. I would suggest at least to keep things interesting and keep like, why are we playing this game now?
Yeah. So I'd like to hear, like, see you guys, the listeners and viewers, if you have any suggestions for what kind of games or even the format of this. I think we're open to it.
Yeah.
And also just definitely. Let us know if you thought this, if this was a terrible idea.
Yeah.
Like, just don't do this. Stick to radio.
Yeah. Definitely. Please, like, any comments or suggestions or points that should be addressed. If the audio was terrible, if the video quality was completely shit, or the fact that the two people in the top right corner were
obnoxious and just unbearable to listen to.
Like we'll figure it out. So Modem won't be back next Tuesday because it's the fall break, but we'll be back the week afterwards. That will be the, let me check my calendar, that'll be the 25th. So go check out radiomodem.dk once we had that point on the Tuesday around 4:30, which is 16:30, to put it so everyone understands. We'll let you know once we do, if we do this again, which we'll probably will.
Yeah.
How to watch it.
Thank you so much for the feedback.
Yeah.
And thank you, Hex Black, Daniel.
I guess is it, Nils, this has been a lovely journey to take with you.
It's been great going for the ride with you, Sebastian.
It's good.
Okay, let's
see you again. Figure this out at one point, and the rest of you guys have a great night.
Yeah,
I'm gonna go get some food.
Yeah, thank you guys.
Bye.
Bye.